Now can you guys hear me? I swear to God, I selected a Twitch stream in my FF split options. I always record locally first, just to test the video, to test the audio levels and everything. And I swear to God, I switched it over to streaming on Twitch, but the option did not take. It says I'm live, so I'm going to trust it. Let's sync the chat room again. Enter. Like I was saying, I'm not sure how much good syncing the chat is going to do, since Twitch's chat servers have been pretty much completely dead. They seem to be working okay now, but who knows how long it'll last. Shout out to CPC Gamer, Galen, Bippo, and Just Drop. Thanks for hanging out. Okay, so let me go over my whole opening spiel again. Happy Friday, by the way. I played a little bit of this game last night, and I'm not really sure how I feel about it yet. There is a lot that I like about it, but I have some pretty big problems with it as well. I do think it's worth taking a look at and streaming. It's possible that I'm playing wrong, so if any of you have any tips or anything for me, let me know. I'm not sure how many of you have played this game, but I'm going to jump in here. I've unlocked one class, the Enforcer. Commando is the default, and there's quite a few classes here. I haven't played the Enforcer at all yet. I was talking to Pinfeldorf about this game the other day, and he suggested that I might like the Enforcer class, but he warned me that it's a lot slower than the Commando, and that kind of made me hesitate, because the Commando is already pretty slow. I'm not really that happy with how he plays, so I'm going to stick with the Commando for now, because I sort of know what I'm doing with him, and then I'll try the Enforcer a little bit later on. I'm playing on Rainstorm, which is the kind of default normal difficulty. I avoided Drizzle because it says progress is not saved in this mode, but apparently all that means is high scores aren't saved. You can still actually unlock things, which it would have been kind of nice if they actually told you that, but I'll stick with Rainstorm because that's just what I'm used to. So let's start her up. I am playing with a controller, and it is kind of nice because this game actually supports, you know, any controller. It doesn't have to be an Xbox 360 controller. I have four abilities. The double tap is the Commando's main ability, just kind of two quick shots. And then he also has a roll, which he can use to dodge enemies, and you are immune while you're rolling. And you also have kind of a penetrating shot that can go through multiple enemies, that's that one. And then a quick burst that does a pretty good amount of damage. Now I see a Duke's up, y'all. Okay, great. So, up in the top right-hand corner, you will notice a timer. And right now, the timer says very easy. One of the things that I don't like about this game is that the longer you play, the harder the game gets. Which, you know, that's how games normally work, you know. In higher levels, in later levels, the game gets more difficult. But in this one, you're kind of always at the mercy of the timer, and I don't really like time limits in games. Now Spelunky has kind of a soft timer with the ghost, and that I'm fine with that because the ghost is easy enough to deal with. You know, normally you're not going to take longer than 2 minutes and 30 seconds in a level unless you're ghost mining or doing something unusual, you know, exploring, looking for the black market or something. So your goal is to find the teleporter in every level, and that's, I actually just stumbled across it, which is pretty fortunate for me, since I'm only, 2 minutes into it. So, once you find the teleporter and activate it, that'll summon the boss of the level. and you have to stay alive for 90 seconds. Okay, this is the Colossus, which is probably the easiest boss to deal with. I've seen three so far. And once the 90-second timer counts down, then you have to kill every enemy in the level. So, wow, that's a lot of fall damage. So you're sort of, it's a real balancing act, because you lose all of your money at the end of every level. Once you kill all the enemies, and, once you kill all the enemies, you go back to the teleporter and you leave the level. But, like I said, you lose all of your money. So, that item I picked up is a war banner, which every time I go up a level, this thing drops down, and it, I don't know exactly what it does. It makes you more powerful while you're in this little radius. Oops, that's the wrong button. Which, I'm not 100% sure how useful it is. Huh, wow. It's a Venn diagram of power there. So, the other thing I don't like about this game, there are two main problems I have with this game. There are the timer, and the fact that enemies just kind of randomly spawn out of nowhere. Like, you can be clearing out an area trying to, you know, get a chest or something, and just an overwhelming number of enemies can just pop up out of nowhere and just completely ruin your day. Wow. There are three levels in that tiny little zone. It's kind of beautiful, actually. Alright, so I have 11 enemies remaining, which is good, because that means I'll finish up this level relatively quickly. Normally it takes me about 10 minutes to finish a level, just because the teleporter is usually not, so close to your starting point. And you slowly regenerate health as you play, but there are items, of course, that let you heal faster and heal more frequently and stuff. Killing enemies sets the ground on fire. That sounds like a good one. I have a lot of money to spend, so let me see. I can get a random item. That is a use item that lets you slow down time, and I'm not sure what that one does. Let's get this one. See what that does. Oh yeah, summon a ghost for every enemy on the screen. That's a pretty good one. The items you collect are either passive items, which are down in the bottom left-hand corner of the screen, or use items, which you have one use slot. And I'm going to go ahead and use my jar of ghosts and summon basically a copy of every enemy. It didn't summon a copy of the Colossus, though. That's kind of disappointing. But as you can see, they are messing up the enemies in this area pretty good. They don't last that long, but everything has a countdown timer, so I will get another use of that item here in 15 seconds. So since you lose all of your money at the end of every level, oh, I have two more enemies to kill. Increase health regeneration, and armor. That's pretty nice. You can look around for things to spend your money on. Well, that guy's just standing there. But of course, the thing about having the timer constantly going is that every second you waste is 1 second closer to your eventual doom. That's a good item. And that's a drone that follows you around and attacks enemies. And I have one more guy here to kill. Let's open this chest. Mysterious vial. Increase health regen. That's good. Alright, so I killed every enemy in this area. Just under 7 minutes, which is a pretty good time from what I understand. Normally it takes me 10 to 12 minutes. And I'm going to lose all this money, but better to do that than... Oh, shit. Oh yeah, that's right. Your money is converted to experience points. It's not that many, but it's better than nothing. The way I describe the game, it sounds like Power Up Forever. Not familiar with that. it is an action roguelike in that you do have permadeath and the levels are randomly laid out. But it's sort of like, it's kind of similar to The Binding of Isaac. You unlock character classes and you unlock items you can potentially find during the course of the game. And I've unlocked, well, the commando, or not the commando, the enforcer, like you guys saw at the beginning. And I unlocked a couple items. Don't remember exactly which ones they are. I guess I could use my jar of ghosts on this guy. Even though there's only one person on this, well, now there's two. See, look at that. I just spent all that time trying to kill that thing, and then another one just pops up and spawns out of nowhere. It's really kind of disheartening. But I have my drone following me around and adding to my damage. See, that guy just spawned right on top of me. That's really... And he teleports around, too. And there's another one. So, this is as far as I made it in this game. I've never made it past stage 2, because the difficulty just kind of ramps up. Even though it still says easy up next to the timer, I don't know. It seems very hard to level up, to keep pace with the time limit in this game. Like, it takes so much time to kill enemies once you reach this point. My drone died, so I had to fix it again. Jesus! And these guys just appear out of nowhere. Like, I mean, the combat... You're basically playing, like, an action RPG, like Diablo or something. You have multiple abilities with slowdowns. With cooldowns, and you just have to manage those, and, you know, basically juggle your abilities as efficiently as possible. I use my ghost jar, but it doesn't look like jellyfish get ghosts. That kind of sucks. And the timer is just always going too. You never get like a moment between levels to kind of rest and recuperate. Alright, I have not explored much of this level. See, that's the problem. You kind of have to... You know, it's a delicate balance of ignoring the enemies, but you still have to kill enough enemies to level up. Fire shield. Retaliate on taking heavy damage. Oh, that's probably pretty good. And you just move so slow too. Like these enemies, they move faster than me. It's just, I don't know. Maybe there's something I'm missing, and I just don't get like what's good about this game. I mean, there's a teleport. Cool. I know what's good about this game. You know, it's, a healing drone. That would be nice to have. The healing drones are incredibly useful. I don't have enough money yet, though. Alright, so I just have to survive for 90 seconds. Okay, gotta remember that healing drone's there. God, it's so overwhelming. Just a billion enemies just spawn, and there's not much you can do about it. So yeah, but I mean, the good thing about this game is, you know, the items are cool, the character classes seem cool, the combat's theoretically cool. I'm not good at it. Oh my god. So I don't know. There's something I'm missing. Wow, that jar of ghosts is freaking awesome. Okay, see, moments like that are really cool. Maybe I just have to start using my items more effectively or something. Alright, let's go revive that helium drone. Oh crap. Oh, that was a heavy fall. Alright. Healing drones, they heal you much more rapidly than your normal regeneration. God, there's just so much shit on the screen. I kinda just wanna run and just use my jar of ghosts over and over again. That thing's pretty good. It's just absolute chaos. And I mean, it's not like in the Binding of Isaac where, you know, once you clear a room, you have a minute to kind of, falling to low health stops time. Oh, interesting. Like, in the Binding of Isaac, you have, like, a moment of respite between every room. Wait, what was that? Oh, my drone died. That sucks. I don't think I have enough to revive it either. But in this game, it's just non-stop chaos. Alright, ghosts, do your thing. Like, the only way I can really look at the chat is to pause it. And that kind of sucks because it makes the music stop. Oh well, at least I'm actually clearing out enemies now. It doesn't feel so, like, pointless to kill enemies because I found the teleporter and I'm actually working towards, working towards clearing the level out. You know, before you find the teleporter, I mean, killing the enemies, I mean, sure you get gold and experience and stuff, but you feel like you're fighting an unwinnable battle. I guess I just have to ignore the enemies to a certain extent until I find the teleporter. I'm not sure. But then, you know, maybe I'm not going to be a high enough level. Twitch says I left the chat room. Great. I have the Steam chat open. I forget if I mentioned this or if that was before I actually started streaming. But if you aren't a part of the Steam community group, go to dukeofthebump.com and click on Steam group, and that'll take you to where you can join. You have to actually have Steam installed to use the chat room though, which I figure most of you probably do. But it's an alternative to the Twitch chat room. Oh my god. I can't keep track of which enemies are the ghosts and which ones are actual enemies. Alright, I'm at 15 minutes. It's actually not bad. Like, I've had games where it took me longer than this to get past level 1. So, compared to that, I'm doing okay. I'm not actually sure what that enemy up there is. Oh wait, that's a new boss, the Ancient Wisp, that I haven't even damaged yet. And the Jar of Ghosts does not do anything for bosses. Kinda sucks. Ow. Oh, does this guy summon enemies? There was just one enemy a second ago, right? I think he summoned that little fire dude. Like, I'm not even sure how easy it is to see what's going on because everything in this game is so tiny. The window is, I'm pretty sure it's 1280 by 720, the same thing that, same size window that I used with Spelunky. So, I don't know, hopefully it looks okay. Oh my god. Ghosts! Oh, that guy dropped enemies when he exploded. Jesus Christ! Like, I kinda don't wanna play as any class besides the Commando, because I can't imagine not having this roll ability. It saved my ass so many times. Because you're invincible when you're rolling. But presumably the other classes have have similar things. Alright, repair that. Wasn't there a chest around here somewhere? God, I want to go spend some of this money, but I don't want to take that much time. Snake Eyes, gain increased critical strike chance on failing a shrine. Haven't found a shrine yet in this playthrough, but it's basically spend money on a chance to get an item. It's sort of a crapshoot. All right, I don't see any more chests in the immediate area, so I think I'm just going to get out of here. In 17 minutes. And see, it's not really even that much experience either. Alright, let's take a breather. I really like the second character, even though he's slower, his utility is much greater as his ability to kill enemies. Yeah, I'll probably try him after I lose this run, which is pretty inevitable. What resolution is my monitor? 1920 by 1080. So, you know, basic HDTV resolution. Leveling doesn't change much apart from health. Luck is always a factor. Really, leveling seemed to have a pretty significant effect on the amount of damage I was dealing. But maybe they were just items. Graphical style reminds me of something halfway between Flashback and EG. Yeah, it's pretty nice looking, despite, you know, the simplicity of the characters, which, I mean, they're so small, they have to be pretty simple. Alright, give me one moment and I will continue with level 3. Okay, sorry about that. I actually really like the Jar of Ghosts. I'm just going to have to remember to use it at opportune times. Alright, oh, there I am. Couldn't figure out where I was for a moment. See, it would have been really nice if I could have brought that money with me so I could get that mystery item. Oh wow, the enemies have 2 health bars now. That's crazy. Oh my god, these guys take so long to kill. Oh wait, am I underwater? Yeah, I guess I am. Hence the sunken tombs level. That's kind of cool. Can I swim? No. Oh crap, can I fall off the world? Oh, okay. It doesn't kill me, it just kind of respawns me. That's good. Do the enemies respawn if I knock them off the world? I hope so, otherwise I would lose out on all that awesome money. Well, I mean, the enemies are going to constantly respawn until I activate the teleporter anyway. So it's not like it makes that big of a deal. That much of a difference. Alright, this is one of the shrines. And I have a chance of, what was it, critical hit damage? Gain increased critical strike chance on failing a shrine. Removed on success. Oh, I see. That's kind of interesting. Alright, well, let's try it out. Okay, I didn't get anything, but I do have increased critical strike chance now. Which is kind of cool. Maybe I'll revisit the shrine once I get some more money. That die over my head is a pretty good visual cue. I like that design. Ah, crap. Yeah, you can't swim. Does it damage you when you respawn? Nope, not really. That's kind of cool. It just wastes a lot of time, which, you know, that's the most important resource of all in this game. Are those critical strikes? Those little lightning flash things? Jesus. God, these things have a billion hit points. Ghosts! Like, I can barely tell what's going on, so I'd be surprised if you guys can. I mean, my basic strategy in this game is to just kind of, it's like the 2D equivalent of circle strafing, almost. You just kind of lead them back and forth, dealing damage whenever you can. Wait. Oh, time stopped because I was low on health. See, I should be exploring, looking for the teleporter, but there's so much shit to deal with. Ghosts! Alright. Maybe the ghost will just... Oh, Jesus. The closet is here already? What the hell? That's weird. Alright, I'm getting, Oh, cool. Jesus, look at all that money. That's crazy. My drones are almost dead, too. When they start flashing and they have the exclamation point like that, that means they're on the verge of destruction. Man, my ghost... I should just do that more often, just let my ghost wreck shit. Of course, it looked like a lot of money, but it's not even enough to repair my drone, so... Oh, I still have the healing drone, that's the important thing. Ghosts! Okay, there's the teleporter. I'm gonna go ahead and hit that, because I'm wasting some valuable time. See, once you hit the teleporter, it's kind of a relief because you know that all of the time you spend is going to be spent doing something important, like not just killing enemies for no reason. Oh my god, I'm so slow. I'm basically just waiting for my ghost to come back at this point. Jesus! Fuck you, game. Alright, well, I got a bunch of new records. Bosses spawn on their own. I guess that only happened from level 3 on, because I've never seen that happen before. I have a 1280 by 1024 monitor, and it sucks. That does suck. Okay, well, that's the best run I've had yet, so I guess I can't be too sad. I didn't unlock anything, just kind of a bummer. Alright, let's go back to the menu. These are the items I've unlocked. I think the locked ones, these are things that you have to... Basically, it's like an achievement, but not a Steam achievement, just an in-game achievement to unlock these. And these are just, I think these are items that pop up that I just haven't bought yet, which is why they're grayed out. And you can click on each item and get a pretty robust description. The Down Syndrome Brain, that's pretty good. You did good, thank you. The game isn't much deeper than this, honestly, Duke. The fun lies in getting new characters, figuring out their tactics, and finding items that complement them. Well, fair enough. Alright, well, I guess I should go on ahead and try out the Enforcer now. I'm not familiar with any of the characters' abilities, so I probably won't do as well as I did with the Commando. I wish I told you what the cooldown time on this screen was. Alright. Now, this guy doesn't seem that much slower than the Commando. Alright, that's my main ability. It's like a shotgun. And then... Okay, that's my shield slam, I guess. That's close range only. Oh, this is the stance. Okay. Instead of a roll, that button enters a stance that, I'm assuming it's... You take less damage, but you move way more slowly as well. Let's hit up the shrine, see if anything cool happens. Nope. Well, teleporter's right over here. So, I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Why not? Magma Worm, I hate this boss. It's a real pain in the ass. He can pop up anywhere, so you kind of have to constantly move. Alright. What's, oh, cool, that's like a stun grenade or something. Ow! So much for constantly moving. Alright, let's try this stance. See, Ow. Oh. I guess, that one didn't actually connect. Ow. That one did. That's a pretty good damage increase. Oh, hey. I unlocked something for my, my enemy log. Let's try the shield bash up close. Oh, that stuns them as well. That's kind of cool. Oh my god. Piggy bank. See, I'm so used to the way the commander controls, I'm hitting the wrong button for everything. Piggy bank basically slowly gives you, money over time. Nope. That wasn't good. Used to be you couldn't move at all. Well, you move so slowly, it's, you might as well not be able to move at all. Alright, well, that didn't go so well. Let's try that again. Alright, so, that button is a stance. It has a 5-second refresh when I come out of it. That button is the shotgun. That one, just my basic move. Okay, that button's a shield bash. It has a 5-second cooldown. Oh, wait, no. That button was... Wait, so what's this button? I don't know what that is. I thought one of them was like a grenade. Oh, you can block stuff? How do you do that? Oh, maybe that's just... Hmm. Sorry, I'm trying to figure out how this character works. So why am I blocking those, but I wasn't blocking the jellyfish? Don't quite get it. Maybe it's just like melee attacks or something, but if the jellyfish isn't doing a melee attack, I don't know what it's doing. Okay, so that's a grenade, I guess. Okay. Interesting. Hi to all the new people in the chat room. Thanks for coming and hanging out. If I attack faster at lower health. Okay, that's cool. If I don't acknowledge you or respond to you, it's because the Twitch chat room is being really dumb. Well, I mean, it's always really dumb, but it's more dumb than normal. Okay, so that definitely hit me. It still hit me. Oh, wait. I still don't really get it. I guess the grenade, like, seeks enemies out. Well, I can definitely see how that shield bash would be useful when I'm surrounded by enemies. Hey, Lulushiro, what's up? And hey, Tarka, what's going on? Oh, wait, I guess I'm at low enough health to attack faster. That's what that little glow around me is. If you want to the new people, you can chat in the Steam chat room. You have to have Steam installed. But just join the Duke of the Bump community. Just go to dukeofthebump.com and click on Steam Group. I can't get up there. See, with the commando in this situation, I can just roll and jump. But I can't do that with this guy. That kind of sucks. Alright, I've wasted a lot of time just trying to figure this guy. Well, there's a teleporter. That's nice. Alright, so even though I'm in the stance, that thing is hurting me now. I don't get it. That thing wasn't hurting me while I was in the stance before. Well, let's go ahead and hit the teleporter. Oh, Jesus. Oh, my God. I tried to climb up the rope, but I couldn't see it. There's a hidden rope, says McGack. Oh, to get that chest that I couldn't get to? I'll have to look more carefully for that next time. Alright, well, still not 100% sold on this character. Let's give it another go, though. His guard isn't the best. Yeah, I don't know what determines when the guard works or not. Is that a heal drone? Nice. I need $40. Oh, hey. Teleporter already. That's cool. Let's see if I can just tank this guy. I need to remember that I can just hold this button down instead of mashing it. Yeah, I can't really knock the Colossus back, which makes sense, I guess. What is kind of nice about the stance is that you stay facing the same direction, so you don't have to turn every time you want to shoot. Okay, well, that wasn't too bad. Chance to knock enemies back. That should be pretty useful for me. Alright, I have $83. What do I want to spend it on? Well, heal drone, first of all. First and foremost. And then, the mech kit would be nice. Ah, crap. Oh, wrong button. Okay, there we go. Alright, I only have 11 enemies left, so this is going okay. I was hoping those guys would come down so I could hit them while I was still in my stance. I do like how all of the money and experience points is always magnetically drawn to you, so you don't have to waste time picking that up. Although I usually still do anyway because I forget. Oh wait, I didn't actually pick that thing up. That might be a good idea. Alright, I have $80. Pick up this chest. Oh, what does the crowbar do? Oh, bonus damage to healthy monsters, that's right. The med kit was the worst item there, was it? I didn't remember what the other items did, so that's the one I went with. And let's do the shrine. Might as well use the rest of my... You can double up on some items, which is kind of cool. I got doubled up on the boxing gloves and the med kit. That might be good for me, or it might not make that much of a difference. I'm not sure. Crap. See, I wish it would at least, like, go to a stat screen or something between levels. Just give you a moment to catch your breath. Check the direction you're blocking versus the one you're being attacked from. I thought I was. It didn't seem to make that much of a difference. I wish the music didn't stop when you had it paused. Fungal Haven. I mean, part of me just wants to ignore enemies completely until I find the teleporter. Because killing enemies before that point just seemed like such a waste of time. Oh, would you look at that. And it's a magma worm. It's the thing that killed me last time. God, that does so much damage. Oh my god. Why am I attacking so slowly now? Sometimes it seems like my shotgun is faster. I'm not sure if walking through the worm actually does damage to me, or that's just when its head hits me. Like, I'm not sure if walking through its tail does damage or not. Oh my god, I'm so dead. Hey, there's a chest up there. Not sure we're going to be able to get to it. The other jump pad didn't seem to take me quite close enough. Nope, almost. That's weird. I wonder if some characters have like a higher jump or something. That would make it so they can get up there. In that layout. Ow. God, I can't even dodge that worm, I'm so slow. Three, six enemies, that's quite a few. Alright, using my my stance is just out of the question with the magma worm, because I'm never going to have a hope of dodging his attack. Or I guess I could just go in and out of the stance, but I can't dodge the attack under normal circumstances either. God. See, at least with the commando I could roll through that attack, and I'd be okay. If you press jump when you hit the jump pad, you jump higher. Oh, okay. I didn't know that. That worm thing is going to hit me every single time. Alright, well, let's try to... Oh, there we go. Oh, wait. Maybe the jump pads are how I'm supposed to dodge the worm. I'm not really sure. Wait, 7 enemies remaining? Oh, 27. Wait. It said 7 just a second ago, didn't it? I don't know. It keeps switching between 7 and 27. What's the deal with that? Because if it's 7, it's not that bad. Oh, I guess the worm counts as 20 enemies, maybe? Yeah, I guess that's the case. That's weird. See, I blocked that somehow. I don't know. It doesn't seem like the sort of thing I should be able to block. Damn, missed him. At least my heal bot is doing a pretty good job of keeping me alive. And my med kits. Weird that the worm counts as the boss counts as 20 enemies. I don't quite get the rationale for that. Screw you. Wish I had some way of like distracting the worm or something. Making it attack somewhere I'm not standing. Gain a shield. Your shield recharges when out of combat. Oh, nice. I've never gotten that item before. Worm has 20 hitboxes. Oh, okay. I guess that makes sense. Alright, well, I guess that worked out okay. Looks like the shield gives me an additional 60 hit points. Because I have 417 out of 357. Alright. I could go down and get that chest. I probably shouldn't press my luck though. It's the underwater level again. Great. Don't worry, you'll get better as time goes on. Yeah, that's what I'm hoping. The head bursting through hurts, and the fire trail it leaves behind hurts. Wasting time early on can be helpful because you will have more items and levels. Yeah, I guess I still don't have a feel for the right balance of not taking too much time, but also making sure you have enough items and levels. The syringe increases your attack speed, which is good on this character. Oh, I'll have to remember that. You can quintuple up on some items. Oh, that's cool. Okay, stop stalling. Sunken Tombs is a great name. Yeah, it kind of sounds like a doom metal band. Or some other sort of extremely depressing music that they play in Scandinavia. Aw, man. Ah, oh, crap, wrong button. Oh my god, that did so much damage to me. Good god almighty. And I don't have my heal bot now. That sucks. Maybe if I get, like, right on the edge, so this thing can just never get behind me. Oh, I guess it can get behind me. But not far enough behind me, apparently. Oh, that one did. That one did. Oh my god. Oh my god. I think that's... Yeah, that green orb... Oh great, two more of them. just what I wanted. That green orb thing, I'm pretty sure it was health. Whoa, what's that? Laser drone. That sounds pretty good. Wish I had $597. Wandering Vagrant. Oh, great. I don't like the bosses that can freely, wait, what's that? Foreign fruits heal on use. Oh, that's cool. I don't like the bosses that can just travel through the terrain. Oh my god, that's not a good strategy. Heal. That was a pretty good heal. I feel good about that. Get away from me. Fuck off. Okay, I can't allow that jellyfish to stay on me. And it's always going to stay on me because I'm not fast enough to run away from it. And my knockback doesn't work on it, apparently. Man, I wish I had my jar of ghosts. That would be so helpful here. Although this fruit is pretty good. I still don't have enough for the laser drone. Yeah, I'm in trouble, guys. Like, I can't stand still for even a second. Alright, heal. Oh! Too late. At least the Vagrant doesn't hurt on touch. It sure looked like it did. Well, at least I have a new record for total score. Love the music in this game, too. This game has really good music. Alright, what do you guys say? Stick with this character, or should I try the commando again? What was that fruit? Heal yourself for 50% of your health. That's pretty good. This guy is so boring. The character I was playing, or do you mean me? Because if you mean me, then I might have to take offense to that, sir. Or madam. Change. Yeah, I'm thinking change back to the commando. I could try it on a lower difficulty and see how much better I do. Oh, the character. Okay. Good. Alright, I'll go back to the commando for now. Which means I have to get used to an entirely new set of controls again. I mean, not entirely new, but... I have to get used to new controls. I mean, the controls are already kind of weird because all of the actions are on the four shoulder buttons. I'm using a PS2 controller, so it's L1, R1, L2, and R2. At least your default attack always seems to be on the R2 button or the right trigger if you're on an Xbox controller. Yeah, this guy's a lot more straightforward. His abilities are shoot, shoot more, and shoot big. And roll. Okay, this guy is way faster than the Enforcer. The Enforcer didn't feel that much slower, but going back to the commando, it's definitely a big improvement. Maybe I'll try the Enforcer again later on, but for now, I like having speed, and I like having the ability to roll. And I like having a pretty simple set of attacks. Is that a heal drone? I think so. Nice. Should be the name of this game. Shoot, shoot more, and shoot big. I think I might make a game called that. And just copy the mechanics of this game. Is this another healing drone? Nice. Never had two of those before. I need $10 more. Now they were saying there was a hidden rope that lets you get up here, but I'm not sure where that is, but since I'm the commando, I can do that. Chance to bleed on hit. Not sure how useful that is, but I'll pick it up. Now look at all that crap. Oh, it's you again. Nice. I'm a big fan, Mr. Jellyfish. Or should I say, not a big fan. Oh my god, ow. My healing drone is already almost dead. I'm already almost dead. Oh my god. Maybe activating the teleporter prematurely isn't a good idea. I mean, it's definitely not a good idea when you get this damn giant jellyfish. Christ. I don't know why you guys were saying he doesn't hurt on touch, because that definitely seems to be the case to me. Sigh. Well, that seemed to be going okay. I don't know, maybe I would be better off just taking my time. Maybe the time limit isn't as big of a deal as I'm making it out to be. Alright, new strategy. I'm going to try to open as many chests as possible. See if that makes up for the additional time I'm using. Hey Kasha, what's up? That guy wants to hug me. I mean, I know I'm a pretty huggable dude, but, you know, personal space, man. Not sure how useful having enemies bleed is. If you die, you won't be alive anymore. Good professional tips from Bippo Ernesti. It seems like sometimes enemies just don't spawn. It's like either you have a billion enemies or zero enemies. I like the sound effect the jellyfish make when you hit them. Reminds me of a sound effect from Cave Story. Duke, how do you like Risk of Rain? I don't know. I'm kind of a mixed opinion about it. I mean, it does a lot of cool things. I don't think it's a badly designed game. I think it does some things I don't like. But maybe I just need to get used to them. I don't know. Nothing. Increased health regeneration. That seems like a pretty good thing. Early game doesn't really spawn that many enemies. So maybe I need to activate the teleporter immediately or as soon as possible in the early game, and then in the late game worry more about finding things. Also, I'm not really sure how fun these shrines are. The magma worm is better than the jellyfish. The colossus is still my favorite, but favorite in that he's the easiest to deal with. But I'd rather deal with this guy than the jellyfish. See, with the commando, I can just dodge that bullshit. Of course, it's kind of not good when there's a billion other things trying to hit you. Can I? I don't think. Oh, I guess I just have to climb up from this one. Maybe. I'm trying to get up here. I don't know if there's anything worth coming up here for. Alright, so I went right through that thing's tail and it didn't appear to harm me. Damn it. Speaking of Cave Story, which do you think is harder, Hell in Cave Story or beating Yama? Well, beating Yama took me a lot more time than beating Hell in Cave Story. They're both really damn hard, but for me personally, I think Yama was a bigger deal. It could work on Drizzle, but you won't have any money after the teleporter. It doesn't feel like a new record. I'm not sure how that's a new record. Yeah. Good. Hit that button. Good button to hit. Yeah, I like this game. I don't think it's going to be the new Spelunky, though. This isn't going to be the next game to capture my attention the way Spelunky did. And the way Binding of Isaac did. Those are the two best action roguelikes I've ever played. Sayama is harder because of the random seed generation. Yeah, that's true. At least with Cave Story, you can just kind of practice beating hell over and over and over again. Okay, this is an imp shrine. When you activate it, it spawns 5 imps, and you have to kill all of them before the time runs out. And if you do, then you get an item of some sort. Like that one gave me Soldier Syringe to increase attack speed. That's an item that someone in the chat room was talking up earlier. And you can do that multiple times. I think eventually it'll run out, like the shrine, the random item shrine. But you can do them a couple times, I think. See, the teleporter was down there, but I didn't activate it yet. I'm going against my instincts. I have a feeling that faster attack is going to end up being a pretty big deal. Okay, so that's the fruit. I wish it told you what these things were before you bought them. That one's a fruit that you activate it to heal yourself. The one on the right was the time-stopping thing, which stops time for, I think, 7 seconds. And then it takes like 40 seconds to regenerate. I don't know what the thing on the left is. So maybe I'll try that just to see what it does. Oh yeah, it's that one. Hurt enemies by falling. This one's not that great. I mean, it's kind of cool, I guess. But I would have rather had the healing fruit. Alright, I used the random shrine and didn't get anything. Took me some time to beat Hell and K's story. I'm not lead at platformer, so it was really frustrating, but fun. Yeah, it took me a really long time to beat Balos. Like, I'd say other than Spelunky, that's probably the hardest thing I've ever done in a video game. Was beating Hell and beating Hell and Cave Story. See, the problem with not activating the teleporter until you get all the items is, with the random shrines, I mean, I'm not sure if you can do the random shrines over and over again, or if they... I know the imp shrines eventually disappear once you use them a couple times. I'm not sure about the random item shrines, though. But, I mean, if you just hit those over and over again, then that could, I mean, you could spend half an hour just doing that. Not sure how hard the game actually gets at that point, because I've never lived that long. What about I Want to Be the Guy? Oh, yeah, that's true. I don't know, I definitely put more hours into Spelunky than I did in I Want to Be the Guy. So, if that's an indicator, then that would make Spelunky the hardest game I've ever beaten. I wonder if getting that fall damage item makes it so you don't take fall damage anymore. That'd be kind of nice. And it doesn't say just hurt enemies by falling. Chance to do double damage. That seems good. God, this thing has so many hit points. I'm just pumping bullets into it. Some of them are double damage, and still. All right, I feel like I have a pretty good combination of items going on with the faster attack and the double damage. That seems pretty good against, like, the trash mobs. Oops, I probably shouldn't have rolled there. Rapidly heal outside of combat. That seems pretty good. Wait, the hell is the other one? Oh, I got the increased critical chance. Huh? Let's try it. Saw meringue. Oh, it's a usable item. Alright, let's go ahead and activate this teleporter. I feel like that's enough messing around. Wow. That seems pretty good. Maybe I can just, like, gate this Colossus off and just kind of cheese him. Oh, wait, no, you can walk through that. Never mind. I'm taking a lot of damage. I think my favorite usable item so far is still that Jar of Ghosts. That seemed really cool. I don't know, Solmering's pretty good. And it has an awesome name. Well, I have some money. Maybe I can go back and... Oh, I guess the shrine does disappear eventually, if you use it enough times. Wait, here's another one up here, though. That's cool. At least something good. Okay, nothing, but that's more a critical damage chance. Fail a shrine 3 times in a row. Oh. Oh, it's good that I recognize my achievement. Zip. Nice. Oh crap, I was on the rope. I must have hit down a little bit by mistake. I saw some money, and that shrine is still there, I think, so maybe I can go back up and hit that a couple times. Now, do all the bosses count? No, I guess not. I wonder how many enemies the Colossus counts as. Looks like a good spot to Solmering. If I don't die. Oop! I died. Can you power up your character in general, or is it a per-run basis? I don't know. I haven't seen anything. I mean, you can unlock stuff. But it's mostly just items that can potentially drop. I don't think there's any way to power up your character just overall. The persistence, I believe, lies in just unlocking the character classes. That's the only lasting, like, character effect. So, I mean, maybe there's, like, a super commando or something that has powered up commando abilities. Okay, one moment. Thank you. Okay. I wish I told you what this item does on this screen, instead of having to go back to the item log and see. Let's see, that's a new thing. ...500% damage. Wow. Where's the thing I just unlocked? It was like a fist. I think. It was like a raised fist. Oh wait, there it is. Oh, I won't actually know what it does until I pick it up. That's weird. How's everyone doing on this Friday night? Fantastic. All right. Wish I had some of these other characters unlocked. They look cool. That thing looks like a weird robot. That thing looks like a mech, kind of. Or like a mobile battle suit. That thing looks like a primate. Well, I guess they're all primates. Well, except the robots. Alright, couple chests off the bat. That I can't use yet. I can hit the shrine though. Nothing. Damn, no luck. Well, okay. At least I know where the teleporter is now. So, once I say, okay, I'm done, it's time to activate the teleporter. I know exactly where I need to go. Duke, will this be a long stream today? Well, I'm going to stream this, I guess, for another 45 minutes. I don't know. I might call Risk of Rain prematurely, but after Risk of Rain, I'm going to switch to Spelunky, and I'm going to at least do the daily challenge, and I might play a little bit more Spelunky since I don't have work tomorrow, because it's Friday. Gotta get down on Friday. Everyone's looking forward to the weekend. Weekend. Alright, chests, be something good. I wonder if the $50 chests are always better than the $25 chests. Or if there's even, like, a qualitative difference. I don't know. I haven't really opened enough chests yet to notice. I think when the life bar has like a white border around it like that, that means the enemy's tougher. I think. I'm not sure. I forgot it was Friday today. Hills, yeah. Looking for the weekend. Alright, let's get one of those $50 chests. At least the chat room is working better than I thought it would. That's a bonus. Rusty jetpack. Increase jump height and reduce gravity. That's kind of cool, I guess. I don't know, jumping doesn't seem super useful. Well, I guess it is. I guess I do jump a lot to avoid enemy attacks. Increased health regen, nice. I kind of wish it would just automatically grab the item when you open the chest. I mean, except when it's a usable item, obviously, because you have to, if you already have one, then you'd have to switch it out. But I mean, if it's a passive item, I don't think there's ever a reason you would want to not immediately get it. Unless it's something that doesn't synergize well with your class or something. I wish the commando had a better AoE ability. I mean, he has that that piercing shot, but could be better. I guess that's what usable items are for. All right, I guess I should activate the teleporter. So I tried a game called Monaco because it was kind of stealthy. Did not like it. Uninstalled it after 4 levels or so. I believe that game is only good if you play co-op. I haven't played it yet. I do own it. But from what everyone said, Monaco is not a game you want to play by yourself. I did watch a stream of it once. The guys from Giant Bomb were playing it. And they seemed to be having fun, but I had absolutely no idea what was going on. Could not follow it at all. But they acted like they were having a good time. I like the ukulele. Ooh, health egg. I like that. I'm not sure how it defines outside of combat. Like, sometimes it seems to work when I'm shooting things. Sometimes not. I don't know. There's a lot of mystery surrounding this game. I guess that's kind of the point of a roguelike, though. Figuring out how the items work. Yeah, I haven't bought the new Humble Bundle yet, but there are a lot of good games in it. Oh my god. I have no, I have the egg. That's the only healing item I have at the moment. See, I don't understand why it's not active right now. Ow. It's probably not a good place to stand. Oh man, I am so dead. See, the egg is never going to stay active because of that damn worm. I'm always going to be in combat because of the worm. Well, maybe not. I don't know. Speaking of bundles, why must they be so tempting? Yeah. I've bought a lot of Humble Bundles that I've never played any of the games in. Like, I bought a Humble Bundle that had, like, a bunch of Ubisoft games, and I wasn't really even that interested in any of them, but it was like $2, so why the hell not? Well, I actually spent like $5 on it because I wanted to beat the average, and I don't think I've played any of the games that I got for beating the average. Oh my god. Yeah, I feel like there is a lot of luck involved in doing well in this game. Like, if you don't get useful items, you're kind of in trouble. Jesus Christ. Nope, I'm dead. I don't know about the current Humble Bundle. None of the games seem really interesting for me personally. I forget what all was in that bundle. I know there were a couple games in there that I liked. Alright. I don't know if I want to play this for another half an hour. I mean, it's interesting. There's a lot that I like about it, but I don't know. I'm not sold. I seem to get that item a lot. Yeah, I think I'll just do a couple more runs here, and then I'll switch to Spelunky. I do still need to unlock the robot. That's the one character I haven't unlocked yet. So, I can do that until the daily challenge starts. I unlocked Meat Boy the other day. Oh my god! That worm just, once it gets a bead on you, there's not a whole lot you can do. Cool if I can knock the worm backwards. I don't think that's gonna happen though. Kinda wish it healed you all the way when you got a level up. Jesus Christ. Dead. Now Duke can put on Super Meat Boy music and play as Meat Boy. Yeah, that's true. Kinda glad that I only paid $6 for this game. Because, I don't know. I don't think I'm going to get that much mileage out of it. Not sure what else to stream at the moment, though. I mean, now that I beat Yama, you know, I'm pretty much done with Spelunky. I don't want to stream the speedrunning or the no gold achievements, because I'm sure those would be just infuriating to watch. There's the get all the characters achievement, and there's... I mean, there's a co-op achievement, which somebody, I forget who said it, but I think it was Bippo, said that the co-op achievement is easy to get on your own, because all you have to do is let one of the characters die and then revive them right before you fight Yama, and or not Yama, Olmec, and then once you fight Olmec, you can just drop them somewhere out of the way. So that they don't get crushed. So I don't know, that might be worth doing. Kind of against the spirit of the achievement, but I don't really have anyone to play locally with. You ever checked out Paranautical Activity? No, I've heard the name, but I don't know anything about that game. It's a pretty good name. I do love a good portmanteau. I don't know. I guess I could try streaming the No Gold Achievement. It would be a lot of me messing up and restarting, though. Which, you know, a lot of the big name Spelunky streamers do a lot of that, just restarting over and over and over again. So maybe there's an audience for that kind of thing. Duke, what kind of muffins are the best? I like blueberry. I don't know if they're the best. Well, yeah, actually, I guess, I guess blueberry would be my favorite. This is a pretty good item. When you stand still for 2 seconds, you heal, like, super quickly. Because all these mushrooms grow, of course, as soon as you shoot or move, the mushrooms disappear. I don't know, I was going to say maybe lemon poppy seed muffins are better, but I don't think they can beat blueberry. For Spelunky, you could show off some stuff you avoided before, meet the mothership, I think that's it. Yeah, I mean, I'd have to go to the mothership to get the robot. And yeah, I could play as Meat Boy now that I have him unlocked. Paranautical Activity is an FPS with Zelda-style dungeons. Well, that sounds good. It would depend on how the FPS part played. Because there's that one game, Tower of Guns, that just dropped, gifted me a while back. And I checked that out. It's a roguelike FPS. And it seemed neat. But the way the FPS, the way the character moved, and the way the guns worked, were just super, super bad. Like, I think the game was designed, I don't know, it was either Unity or the Unreal Engine, but, like, the way that game controlled just felt absolutely terrible, so I didn't play that much of the game. So, sorry, just dropped. It was in, like, super early access before. It was, like, pre-beta, even, I think. It was, like, alpha. So, maybe it's gotten better. Oh yeah, stacking my fungus. Oh, having two weapon runes seems pretty good. Let's kill some imps. Come here, you. Oh, another jetpack. Nice. Wow, that's a pretty good jump height. My button. Yeah, I think it was in Unity, come to think of it. That Tower of Guns game was made in. Which, you know, Unity is good for how accessible it is. Like, a lot of really low-budget indie games are made with Unity, and there's been a lot of cool stuff in Unity, but I don't know if it's ideal for a first-person shooter that feels good. Don't know how good the War Banner is, because I'm not sure what the actual bonus is you get when you level up. Hmm. I'm doing pretty good damage now with these two drones. Still have no idea where the teleporter is, though. I wanted to explore off to the left, but this area is, like, blocked off. Or I have to go a long way around. Another war banner. A lot of, doubling up this game. Now, this might be a picky gripe, but does a game camera need to be this far back? Yeah, I don't know. I mean, you do kind of need to... Oh, that thing's behind a wall. You do kind of have to be aware, like, super aware of your surroundings. But I'm not sure, it needs to be this far back. Wow, three of these drones, that's pretty awesome, actually. I do feel like kind of a badass now. Taking these things down super easily. Of course, I do have to be careful not to get them blown up. Oh, it's a freaking, wait, is that the jellyfish? Yeah. God dang it. I really wish you could jump off of the ropes, too. Like, being used to Spelunky, I really want to, like, get to the top of the rope and then jump off to land on the platform above. You can't do that in this game. I mean, not that I should reasonably expect every game to control exactly like Spelunky. But, I mean, Spelunky just controls so good and spoiled. Oh, took out a boss. That's nice. I can't read what that says. Something to enemies over time. Don't usually take out the boss before the 90-second period is up. That's kind of unusual. Chance to slow and damage enemies over time. Okay, I guess that's what that little radiation mark over their heads is. Oh my god, that's so much damage. Thirty-five enemies left. It's quite a few. And that's not even counting the boss. Because I already killed it. Let's see how much better it is now that I have two of these banners. See if it's a noticeable difference. I don't know. Really hard to tell. See, you can jump off the rope. Well, you can jump like that, but if you're in the platform, you can't jump off. Like, you can't jump off from here and then get up onto the platform. It's kind of annoying. Oh, there goes one of my drones. Oh my god, there goes me almost. Jesus, that's just the pit of hell on this platform. Oh my god. I wish there was a, oh, there's another one of my drones. Oh my god. My poor drones. I should just keep jumping and just let my drones take out that hell pile. That cuddle puddle. That's going to take way too long. But as soon as I set foot on this platform, it's just Dante's Inferno. And not the, not even the game, the actual literary Dante's Inferno. And the game was pretty bad, so imagine how bad the real thing is. I'm glad I had enough money to keep my drones alive. Having 3 drones is quite nice. Alright, one more and it is off to the right. At least it gives you a direction arrow on this part. I've probably taken way too long on this level though. Yep, go away. See, I wish you could pause and see what your items do instead of having to keep the clock running. Just a lot of little changes I think would help this game a lot. Crap, I have a lot of money. Oh well. Not even enough to get me up a level. Alright, Spelunky messed me up the same way as his Bibbo. I keep trying to jump on enemies and grab ledges and canes where that's not really an option. Yeah, going from Spelunky to Mario was definitely a weird transition for me. Because I'm playing 3D Land on the 3DS. I have an extra copy of Paranautical Activity if you want to check it out. Yeah, that'd be cool. If you don't mind. I mean, if you're offering. The price can be a bit steep for what it's asking right now, but it's still early access. Huh. Derek, you should put Bandage Girl as a damsel in the game. Yeah, that'd be neat. The replayability of a PA isn't amazing, but it's fun if you enjoy shooting things. I do like shooting things. Alright. Sorry, I have to kind of pause and chat dump. I can't really look at chat while I play this game at all. I feel like I have a pretty good set of items going on right now. I guess the drones can't shoot through rock. Of course, every time I say I have a good set of items, I get overwhelmed and die. So maybe my no hubris rule should apply to this game as well as Spelunky. Oh, cool! Thanks, dude. Thank you very much, Pippa. That's really awesome of you. Oh, this is another kind of shrine where instead of giving money, you get hit points. And it's not max health, thank God. It's just, it does that much damage to you. But, you know, with my mushrooms, it might be feasible for me to sit here and just kind of farm it. Let my mushrooms grow. And my health just comes back so quickly. Am I actually getting anything for that, though? It doesn't look like that. Am I just getting a monkey with that every time, or is it doing something that I'm not aware of? Because, I mean, if it's like the other shrine, then an item would pop up. Oh, poor drones. Wait, what kind of drone is that? See, all I want to do is stand still for a few seconds and heal. And it does not look like the game is going to let me. Okay, there it goes. In hindsight, I hope you have pop-ups off. Well, you couldn't see the whole URL, so... I don't think it's, I don't think people are going to be able to steal the code or anything. I should probably turn pop-ups off. Usually I go offline in Steam when I do a stream, but I don't have enough money for that. But since I have the group chat open, then I left Steam open. Should be fine though. I'm in trouble. There's a lot of enemies and not much I can do about them. Pretty sure that he was invisible anyway. I didn't get a good look at it. All I saw was humblebundle.com/gift or something. Alright, well, what do you say we switch to Spelunky? I don't know. This game, seems neat. I don't know if it's for me. I've completed 18.2% of the game. My favorite item is this thing, apparently. Oh, that's that's the Jar of Ghosts. That's definitely my favorite item. Seems like a pretty good number of unlockables. Okay, well, stay tuned. I'm going to switch over to Spelunky. The stream's going to go offline, but I'll be back in just a couple minutes.